Good morning. Welcome to Christ the King. Our processional hymn this morning is Praise the Lord, the Almighty, the King of Creation.
His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you our hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ says. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, the spirit to think and to do always those things that are right, that we who can do no good thing apart from you may by you be enabled to live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And a calling for the selection of a bishop. Almighty God, giver of every good gift, look graciously on your church, and so guide the minds of those who shall choose a bishop for the diocese, that we may receive a faithful pastor who will preach the gospel, care for your people, equip us for ministry, and lead us forth in fulfillment of the Great Commission through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We'll now have the reading of God's Word.
A reading from Zechariah chapter 9, beginning with verse 9. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. Righteous and having salvation is he, humble and mounted on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem. And the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall speak peace to the nations. His rule shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 145, beginning with verse 1. We will read the psalm responsibly by whole verse. I will begin. I will magnify you, O God, my King, and I will praise your name forever and ever.
Every day will I give thanks to you and praise your name forever and ever.
Great is the Lord and most worthy to be praised. There is no end of his greatness.
One generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your power.
As for me, I will be talking of the glorious splendor of your majesty and of all your wondrous works.
They shall speak of the might of your marvelous acts, and I also will tell of your greatness.
The remembrance of your abundant goodness shall they proclaim, and they shall sing of your righteousness.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, long-suffering, and of great kindness.
The Lord is loving to everyone, and his mercy is over all his works.
All your works praise you, O Lord, and your faithful servants give thanks to you.
They speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power.
That your power may be known to the children of men, even the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures through all ages. A reading from Romans, chapter 7, beginning with verse 21. I find it to be a law that when I want to do right, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of the Lord in my inner being, but I see in my members another law waging war against the law of my mind and making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then, I myself serve the law of God with my mind, but with my flesh I serve the law of sin. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death. For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do. By sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh, in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus declared, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and understanding, and revealed them to little children. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Some of the words found in Matthew 11 are some of the most familiar words that Jesus spoke. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden. Is Jesus referring to work, like physical labor? Well, partly he is. But I think what he's getting at is this. Life is hard. And all of us carry burdens. Burdens from our past, feelings of guilt, embarrassment, shame, what have you. Physical burdens. You know, you don't get out of this life without a number of scars. And we labor and are heavy laden when we don't know the Lord. And it's when we come to know the Lord Jesus Christ that we have someone who is able to bear all of our burden, all of our guilt, all of our shame, all of our despair and disillusionment. He's able to bear all of that on the cross. And he did that. It's a completed act that he has borne our sins and our burdens. The consequence of his bearing our load, a load that we're not able to carry, we're not able to bear our sin completely because of where it leads. It leads to spiritual separation from God, ultimately death, spiritual death. That was our trajectory and our destiny without Christ's intervention. But now, because of Christ, he's able to bear our burdens and to give us peace with God through his atoning sacrifice on the cross. And the consequence for us is that Jesus says, I will give you rest. Notice that rest is mentioned twice here in just a few verses. It's from the Greek word to rest or to stop. Jesus is able to intervene on our lives, that the sin way of life, of looking to ourselves to get out of our hole, get out of our jam, with all of the accumulated guilt and despair and bewilderment that we are carrying, can't be borne by us without it causing us to self-destruct. And we do, but Christ has done something for us. He bears our punishment. He bears our sins away. And we have rest from him. Take my yoke upon you. The idea is a double yoke. It is a picture of where the oxen were yoked. A more experienced ox would be yoked to a less experienced, younger ox. And that's the picture here, is that Jesus is there and the more experienced ox actually bears more of the load than the younger ox. And when you think about it, yes, he's borne all of our deserved punishment on himself. And learn from me. Learn my way, Jesus is saying. By coming to him, by listening to his promise, that he is there to give us rest. He does give us rest. When we hear that, faith comes through hearing and by hearing from the word of Christ. And we learn from him as we listen to him. We listen to Jesus speak to us. Learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart. He is completely humble. He wants us to be with him. And you will find rest for your souls in Christ. That's the promise of God. We will find rest, real rest. Not thinking so much of a vacation rest, although nothing wrong with a vacation here and there. But it's that inner peace that Jesus brings. That's what he's referring to here. That we know, despite what's going on around us with COVID and other things going on, we don't have to allow the external world in and cause us turmoil. We have inner peace, not because it's, you know, meditation or anything like that. It's because we have that certainty, that knowledge that Jesus is with us. That's how we obtain rest. It's by relying on the promise of God that he is with us in the midst of everything we're going through by the indwelling power of the Holy Spirit. We know that we know that we know that he is with us, and that we can turn to him with anything that we're going through and say, I can't do this anymore, Lord. Help me. And he does. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. A lot of us carry a lot of stuff in our lives, even when we know the Lord. And the challenge for us is to go to him and express that we just can't make it right now. We are programmed in our culture to be self-starters and to do stuff, which is good and it's necessary, but it only can take us so far until we reach our physical limitations and mental and spiritual limitations without God and his help. And help has come through Christ. Go to him today. Listen to his promise found in these words of Matthew. Come to me, all who labor, and we all do labor, and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. For my yoke upon you, take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart. You will find rest for your souls. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. Amen.
We now continue with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Almighty and ever-living God,
We are taught by your holy word to offer prayers and supplications, to give thanks for all people. We humbly ask you mercifully to receive our prayers. Inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant all that who confess your holy name may agree in the truth of your holy word and live in unity and godly love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray that you will lead the nations of the world in the way of righteousness, and so guide and direct their leaders, especially Donald Trump, our president, and Michelle Lujan Grisham, our governor, that your people may enjoy the blessings of freedom and peace. Grant that our leaders may impartially administer justice, uphold integrity and truth, restrain wickedness and vice, and protect true religion and virtue. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give grace, Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, and especially to your servant Foley, our Archbishop, the Standing Committee of the Diocese of the Southwest that is beginning the search for our next bishop, to Pete, our priest, and Bill, our deacon, that by their life and teaching, they may proclaim your true and life-giving word, and rightly and duly administer your holy sacraments. And to all your people, give your heavenly grace, especially to this congregation, that with reverent and obedient hearts, we may hear and receive your holy word, and serve you in holiness and righteousness all the days of our lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Prosper, we pray, all those who proclaim the gospel of your kingdom throughout the world, and strengthen us to fulfill your great commission, making disciples of all nations, baptizing them, and teaching them to obey all that you have commanded. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask you in your goodness, O Lord, to comfort and sustain all who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We remember before you all your servants who have departed this life in your faith and fear, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we ask you to give us grace to follow the good examples of your king, of your saints, that we may share with them in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty God, Father, Lord Jesus Christ,
maker and judge of us all, we acknowledge and lament our many sins and offenses, which we have committed by thought, word, and deed, against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your righteous anger against us. We are deeply sorry for these our transgressions. The burden of them is more than we can bear. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may evermore serve and please you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who sincerely repent and in true faith turn to him, have mercy upon you, pardon them all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Our offertory hymn is His Name is Wonderful. All things come of thee, O God.
And of thine own have we given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right, our duty and our joy always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, who forever say this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
All praise and glory is yours, O God and Heavenly Father, for in your tender mercy you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And he instituted, and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue, a perpetual memory of his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. So now, O merciful Father, in your great goodness we ask you to bless and sanctify with your word and Holy Spirit these gifts of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. For on the night that he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and when given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you, and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me. Therefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of your dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, your humble servants, celebrate and make here before your divine majesty with these holy gifts the memorial your Son commanded us to. Remembering his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and his promise to come again. And here we offer and present to you, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies to be reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice. We humbly pray that all who partake of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood. Your Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with your grace and heavenly benediction, and in one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as the Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The gifts of God for the people of God. The peace of God, passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and the Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Well, hello. A few announcements for you. We're really excited purchasing the building at 2525 Vermont Street Northeast, and so please continue to keep our moving in process in your prayers. We got a few things to do in terms of maintenance. And so that's taking a little longer than we'd like, especially getting the air conditioning unit in the sanctuary fixed. The rest of the building's fine, but the sanctuary, it's pretty toasty. And, you know, it's 100 degrees or thereabouts almost every day now in Albuquerque. So we're praying for the repairs to be done quickly, and so that we can enjoy our sanctuary in relative comfort. Also, to let you know that the election of the bishop is ongoing, and so keep that in your prayers. There's lots of information about that to be found on the AnglicanSW.org website. That's the Anglican Church, or the Anglican Diocese, I should say, in the Southwest, so the Southwest website, AnglicanSW.org. There's lots of information how you could suggest a name to the committee of which I chair. And so we receive names, and then we ask the individual if he's interested in moving forward in our discernment process. And if so, he's got some background information for us to provide, also answers to a question. Questions and spiritual biography, things like that. Anyway, lots of information found on the website if you're interested. But certainly keep that in your prayers. We're looking to close out receiving names from this diocese and from bishops in the Anglican Church in North America July 30th. Okay, this is July 5th. You know, TikTok, but. I am pleased to report we've received several suggested names, and there are several who are moving forward in the discernment process. So this is very, very encouraging. And we're going to be releasing the names on August 12th to the diocese. So stay tuned for that. And we're looking to elect our bishop on December 12th. December 12th will be the electing synod of this diocese. And what we do in the Anglican Church in North America is that we make a selection, but it's actually the College of Bishops that confirms the selection and then consecrates that individual. So it isn't like it's a rubber stamp by the College of Bishops that they just automatically approve of our choice. No, we hope they do so, but it's actually their call. It's actually the college's call. And so it's a process of multiple layers of discernment. But through it all, we pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to guide the selection process so that we know that the man that we vote for and that the college affirms and consecrates is indeed the man called to be our bishop here in the Southwest. Keep that in prayer. See you soon. God bless you.
Our recessional hymn is Lift High the Cross.
Thank you.
Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.